for by about 5. Carl.
The House goes back to work today as lawmakers try to reach a debt limit deal. And joining us this morning with that discussion, Congressman Kevin Brady, Deputy Whip and Senior Member of the House Ways and Means Committee. Also, Congressman Rob Andrews is Ranking Member of the Health, Employment, Labor and Pensions Subcommittee. Congressman, good to see both of you.
Good morning.
Thank you.
Congressman Brady, we're still trying to digest this David Brooks piece from yesterday and some of the ancillary commentary from the likes of Politico, where they said it's a huge no-brainer at this point for the GOP to declare victory and raise the debt ceiling, that you basically got what you came for. Is that true?
Well, not yet. We haven't seen any details. Obviously, we're looking for a serious spending cuts, a balance, I think, here on the debt ceiling. One, short-term cuts, substantial to restore confidence that we understand the seriousness of this problem. Guardrails around future spending this decade, especially, to allow us to live within our means again. And then finally, because there is an 800-pound gorilla in the room, which is our entitlements. You know, having that adult conversation, how we get a handle on those very important programs, that's the balance we're seeking. And so far, we haven't seen it yet.
Do you think today or tomorrow's discussions with the White House are going to be any different? Is that, I mean, is there anything different about this meeting than from previous meetings?
You know, hope springs eternal. I'm not sure it is. I think as long as the White House is stuck on a corporate tax depreciation, which if those are the type of silly proposals we're seeing, I'm not too optimistic.
Congressman Andrews, what do you think about tomorrow's?
I think we're going to make a lot of progress and get a deal the end of this month. I think the deal will and should be in the $4 trillion range, which puts us in a position to cut the deficit by about half. And I think there will be entitlements and revenue in the deal. I don't think that you can have a serious agreement without both of those things being done.
Really? So more being placed on the table by the White House, you think?
Yeah, you look, in the health care bill last year, we were able to enact about $500 billion in Medicare reductions. The Republicans have, by the way, put those $500 billion in the budget that they passed this spring. So there's agreement that you can make changes in Medicare that do not corrupt the integrity of the program. I think the same is true in Medicaid. I know it's true in agricultural entitlements and federal retirement and pension benefits. And I think that these things have to be on the table. And with all due respect to my friend Kevin, I don't think it's silly to say that we shouldn't borrow $60 billion from the Chinese to give it to the oil industry when their own executives say they don't need the subsidy. I think that's something we ought to do.
Well, I wish that were the case. It doesn't make sense to outsource more American jobs. Our energy companies are paying higher taxes than you do, Rob, as a member of Congress, creating jobs here in America.
That's
true. If we're serious about energy companies and the deficit, then let them go to work in the Gulf of Mexico,
in Anwar, in Alaska,
because the moratorium itself in the Gulf has cost us over $1 billion of federal revenue. So if we're serious about U.S. energy helping us in the deficit, put them to work.
What about the guy from Shell who came in and testified that that they don't need the $60 billion subsidy? What about him?
Most of our energy production is done by domestic independents, smaller energy producers who very much need those normal routine business incentives to be able to create energy here in America.
It doesn't make sense to
send those jobs and that production overseas, especially in this weak economy.
You know, the best business incentive is $90 a barrel oil. I don't see why we're putting tax money into an incentive we can get $90 a barrel to drill for the oil. It just doesn't make any sense to me. And I think that's the kind of thing that will and should be on the table.
Well, maybe we can just release some more oil from the Strategic Petroleum Reserve.
No,
maybe that'll
that.
Solve it.
Congressman Brady, there'd been some commentary that maybe defense cuts could act as a legitimate substitution for any disagreement over taxes. Is there enough money in that barrel to make up for something else that we cannot agree on?
You know, I think the folks on defense for savings, yes, there is savings there. Clearly in the procurement area, not in troop support and mission support, but the Pentagon wastes money without question in its procurement, which is, you know, a bulk of its budget. We ought to be looking at those savings and efficiencies. We've got, frankly, report after report after report of wasteful spending within the Pentagon. And we've plussed up, I think, some 1,000 civilian workers who make more than $170,000 a year in the Pentagon. Look, there's some room for savings there, no question.
Okay, Congressman Andrews, some have said because of that, maybe the two sides aren't as far apart as it seems from all the rhetoric.
Well, I mean, look, I think there should be revenue on the table. I think that every situation in the 80s and 90s where we've gotten more revenue, we've had growth, not retraction in the economy. But look, how about saving defense money by not spending $130 billion a year in Iraq and Afghanistan? That's where the money is. The idea that we're occupying those countries and spending $10 billion a month or so is just crazy. So I think that's a clear area where we can and should reduce the defense budget.
Would you, if you were a Senate Democrat, would you be afraid to vote on this this twice?
No, of course not. I mean, look, fear of voting is kind of a weird idea. We're sent to Washington to make decisions, not to dilly-dally around. So I wouldn't be afraid of voting on things. Let's get to it. Let's get to it and pass an agreement that cuts the deficit by $4 to $5 trillion and includes both entitlements and discretionary and revenue, and let's get the economy back on track.
And that wouldn't be an albatross around your neck going into 2012?
I think the worst albatross is doing nothing and watching this economy continue to hit the skids. I think the best course of action is to really honestly address this problem, and that's what we will and I think should do.
Well, that $4 to $5, I saw they tried to push back a little with David Brooks. I saw an unnamed Republican source saying, yeah, it's a great piece, but Brooks says that they've already identified, or the president has conceded $2 trillion or $3 trillion, when that's not the case. It's a single T. It's a $1 trillion, and it's not even specific what he's talking about. You just really did say $4 to $5 trillion. I mean, that's really stepping up to the plate. And if that were to be the case, don't you think you probably would be able to do something with
I think that we will. And look, we better step up to the plate, Joe, because I think we've got a situation here where there's an expectation we're going to have an adult moment, that we're going to have a real agreement to get something done. I think something short of that would be harmful to the economy. So as the president said yesterday, we have an opportunity to do something big here. Let's do it. Well, I agree with him.
I don't think he's ready to do that. You need to talk to him.
Well,
he needs, you got his phone number?
Obviously he watches this program, Joe. I'm sure he's seeing this. And he said it himself yesterday. He's ready to step up to the plate.
Awesome.
And I think Kevin and I are ready to step up there with him.
Last word from you, Congressman Brady. You don't seem as convinced as Congressman Andrews.
Well, I think we want to get to the same point. I think the $4 trillion level is where we need to be. The cuts have to be significant. The budget guardrails and reforms have to be real. The entitlement issues have to be meaningful and not just more rhetoric. I just haven't seen, I'm optimistic at the end of the day, we're going to pay our debts, but we have to change our spending behavior. And I just haven't seen on paper anywhere cuts and reductions and real reforms of that measure. I hope it's there.
All right. We'll see what happens at this meeting tomorrow. Appreciate your time this morning. Thank you, Congressman Brady.
Thank you.
And Andrews.
Appreciate it.